Hello. Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church here in Brookfield, Wisconsin. My name is Brian Halverson, and I'm the pastor here at St. John's Lutheran Church. And this is the second Sunday after Easter. We're so glad that you have joined us. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. Let us pray. Holy and righteous God, you are the author of life, and you adopt us to be your children. Fill us with your words of life that we may live as witnesses to the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our first reading is from Acts 3, verses 12 through 19. Peter addressed the people, "You Israelites, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us as though by our own power or piety we have made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, had glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer given to you, and you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know. And the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Our second reading is from 1 John 3, verses 1 through 7. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, just as he is righteous. This is...
The Gospel is from the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 36 through 48. Jesus himself stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy, they were disbelieving and still wondering. He said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I love this story. Let's take a moment to really dwell in it, to see if we can't picture it in our minds of what is happening here. So Jesus appears to his disciples, and his first words are, "Peace be with you." And Luke says that they were startled and terrified. Well, yeah, I would be terrified too if someone who I thought was dead was standing right in front of me. And I love this part. He said to them, "Why are you frightened?" "Oh, I don't know. This happens to me all the time." "Not." "And why do doubts arise in your hearts?" Again, I've got to picture the disciples standing there with their mouths open, not comprehending what the words Jesus was saying. They'd be bouncing off my head because the thought of, well, the actuality of seeing a dead man talking and walking would be beyond my comprehension. So he says, look at my hands and my feet. See that it is myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have. Oh, that makes a difference. Oh, you're not a ghost. Oh, well, that in that case, yeah, have a seat. We've got some fish here. You can have some. I don't know how the disciples would have had enough wherewithal to absorb what Jesus was saying, and yet it says that he opened their minds to the scriptures. I suppose maybe that's true. Perhaps we are most open when we are most astonished. You know, we live our lives pretty much thinking that we've got things figured out, how things are supposed to run. You know, common sense and reason, we use these quite a lot in our daily lives. You know, the sun comes up, it goes down, just like it does every day. You know, you throw something up and it comes down. That's gravity. We get that. You know, we come to work, we do our work, we go home, cook a meal. It's the same every day. Nothing really out of the ordinary. Although I have to say this. I am a sucker for ghost stories. And I've heard quite a few over my lifetime. Some from people I trust who have experienced the supernatural, if you will. I love those stories. It does open, it opens up, you know, I don't know if it opens up possibilities, or I know a lot of people will dismiss those type of stories. I don't know. I just find it, they're intriguing. But this, yeah, this is not a ghost story. And he confronts the disciples with his presence and astonishes them and terrifies them. And at the same time, it says he opens their minds. And he says, you know, it says in the scriptures that the Messiah is to die and rise again. And here I am. I don't know when the adrenaline rush kind of ebbed away for those disciples after being so terrified. But I've got to believe that just by Christ's presence among them and his words, peace be with you, that there was an overwhelming sense of peace for them. And then I would think, great joy in the astonishment that the scriptures actually had been fulfilled. You know, we in church, we hear about the coming kingdom of God pretty much like the Jews heard throughout their whole lives and throughout the generations, that the Messiah would come. So for us, when we hear the kingdom is coming, the kingdom is coming, I wonder when the kingdom finally comes in its fulfillment, are we going to be just as astonished and almost just as terrified at first when it actually does happen? When it becomes real and not just some promises that you hear in Scripture. It says, touch me and see. What a wonderful reality to touch Jesus and know that the Scriptures had been fulfilled. That wasn't just some stories told long ago, but it's actually true. And we believe in a risen Christ that will come again. I believe we'll still be just as astonished when he comes again as the disciples were. But oh, what love, what glory, what joy it will be to touch him once again. What a gift. What a gift. And so we wait. That's what we do. We're a church, we're a community of faith that waits for the Messiah to come again in his reality. It's not a ghost story. It's a true story. Flesh and blood for a world that desperately needs him, for people who desperately need him to touch and see. What an astonishing, wonderful thing. What a gift. And so, like I said, I love this story. It's very human, isn't it? Just like we are. So, in this Easter season, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Draw me close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm your friend. You are my desire. No one else will do. Nothing else could take your place, but feel the warmth of your embrace. Help me find a way, bring me back to you. Nothing else could take your place, to feel the warmth of your embrace. back to you.
Let us profess our words of faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Living God, in the midst of Easter joy, we are still filled with questions and wondering. Open our hearts and minds as we encounter the Scriptures so that the Church embodies repentance and forgiveness in the name of Jesus to all nations. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all, the nations hunger and thirst for your righteousness. Many call on you for guidance and strength. Answer their hopes with the peace of Christ and give your loving kindness to national, state, and local leaders. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Healing God, you hear the cries of those in need and answer them in their distress. Grant to those who are sick and suffering your compassion and nurse them back to health and wholeness. Be close to the hearts of the lonely. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all times and ages, those who have died in you now see you as you are. We thank you for their lives among us. Assure us of the peace you have promised, that we may join them in everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God of love, you call us beloved children and welcome us to your table. Receive our lives and the gifts we offer. Abide with us and send us in service to a suffering world for the sake of your beloved child, Jesus Christ. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Now please join me in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The body of Christ has been given for you, and the blood of Christ has been shed for you. Let us pray. Wellspring of joy, through this meal you have put gladness in our hearts. Satisfy the hunger still around us and send us as joyful witnesses, that your love may bring joy to the hearts of people. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Just one announcement. We will have in-person worship starting last week, but continuing through the end of May, in-person worship services at 8:30 and 10:15. So please sign up on the Google Sign Up on our webpage to attend our in-person worship, and of course we will continue to have our worship services available online as well. So may our glorious God grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord Jesus, the God of life, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, with righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call, lift your voice, yield jubilee, for out of Zion's hill salvation comes. Flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are as white in the world, and we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining sun at the trumpet call, lift your voice.
Hallelujah! Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Go in peace, following Jesus, making disciples, serving the world. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Behold, he comes.